And back here in Lagos, the governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, says the Apapa traffic menace will soon be history. Now, this is coming after an online call-up system was launched to tackle the persistent traffic congestion in the state. Plus, TV Africa correspondent Aneta Felix files in this report from Apapa.
Nigerians and Nigerian businesses have suffered over the years due to the heavy traffic in Apapa and on the roads leading to Apapa. And several Nigerian governments have tried to find a way to this, but have failed. But recently, the federal government announced that on February 27th, the Lagos State Government and the Nigerian Ports Authority will be putting heads together to commence an electronic call-up system for trailers at the Apapa port.
Before the call-up and coding system for trucks was initiated, Apapa was notorious for its traffic. Commuters spent hours on a journey that should take just minutes. Businesses had to shut down because their offices was inaccessible to clients. Transporters suffered exploitation from law enforcement officers who mounted illegal tolls on the roads. And cargoes were trapped at ports due to congestion. Now, this is the new face of Apapa. Free flow of traffic without a trailer in sight. The new system requires all drivers to park their vehicles at the Lilypond Transit Truck Park, Ijara, and truck drivers can access the port only when called upon. Special Advisor to the Governor of Lagos State on Transportation and the Chairman of the Special Committee on Apapa Traffic Management, Toyin Fayinka, explains more.
If I have 1,000 trucks, I will integrate myself into the Eto app of MPA. So I will download the app. Once I download it, all my truck will be downloaded. So it will go straight into the MPA portal, the Eto app, precisely. All the trucks are captured in their system. So if they need 1,000 trucks in the port, for instance, your own truck, my own truck, will be called upon, and then we move it. Once they give us e-tag, we move into the Apapa.
Some transporters at WAF Apapa praise this, because of the reduced cost for them, as well as the new state of the roads.
It's more preferable than before. And if this thing can be going like this, it will be okay. Even for the people around us, like people living around this place. Like now, they have a free movement now.
Before, then they used 250 or 300 to pass motor, reach inside ports. But as at now, government are collecting maybe 40,000 or how much from 45,000 from Lilypond.
I've worked in Apapa since 2011. And as you can see, the road is fair now. But the fighting issue is that whether they're going to maintain it or not.
Even commuters show their delightful surprise on social media, tweeting applauses to the Lagos State Government. I ask Mr. Fayinka about concerns over the sustainability of the status quo, and he makes this promise to Nigerians.
It's going to be a continuous exercise. It's not that because we have succeeded for 2-3 days, we are going to sleep. We will not. We are not going to rest until it is seen by everybody in the whole world that Apapa Road is clean. We want the deaf to hear and then the blind to see that this is doable.
While Nigerians celebrate the new face of Apapa, stakeholders say taking trailers off the roads is just the first step. To address the problem from its roots, they recommend that shipping companies must have adequate holding bays and Apapa should be converted from a residential area to a restricted economic zone, exclusive for port operations. Aneta Felix, Plus TV Africa.
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.